modern psychiatrist would say, an irrational fear due to the guilt complex of his ancestors keeping these people in bondage. That's how they say it in the press. She is my sister, and Abimelech, king of Gerar, sent, took Sarah. But God came to Abimelech in a dream by night. Now that's something interesting to see. Came in a dream by night. That shows you before the Bible was completed, or even now, if God wanted to deal with the fella, he could deal with him. See, people keep forgetting that thing. So what about the heathen? You don't know what the heathen know. I mean, how do you know some heathen over there in the middle of Africa, how do you know the Lord didn't come down there and say, listen, boy, you got 24 hours to put your faith in Jesus Christ, or you're just good as in hell. I mean, how do you know what to tell them? You don't want to tell them. Well, I remember one night the Lord spoke like that to me and said, this is your last chance. Of course, I've been fooling with the Word of God. Faith comes by hearing Him with the Word of God. But if the Lord knew a case down there where the fellow knew the Word of God and couldn't get it anywhere in the world, don't you worry about the Lord being unjust. The Lord, He'll find a way to do it. And He comes to Abimelech and He says, you're a dead man, for the woman thou hast taken, she's a man's wife. But Abimelech had not come near, and he said, Lord, but thou slay a righteous nation. Now that's a great study there. People say, well, what about the heathen that don't know? That bird knew. And the Lord came down there and says, you're a dead man. Now, if he didn't know, why didn't he say this? What do you mean, dead man? He took another guy's wife. Well, what's wrong with that? I mean, adult consent. I mean, permissiveness. See? I mean, any unsaved heathen knows more about right and wrong than a college professor. They're the dumb bunnies. God had to give a revelation. You have to give it to them. Those heathen people, like old Abimelech, he doesn't have any Bible. There's no Bible written when he says that. Why, Genesis written by Moses, the author of what you're reading, hasn't been born yet. He has no Bible. There are no Ten Commandments. Ten Commandments aren't given until, 430 years after this. So the Lord tells that fellow, you're a dead man. You take another man's wife. You notice he didn't argue with the Lord about it. He just says, why, don't kill me. He said, I didn't touch her. Look at verse 5. Said, in the integrity of my heart, in the innocence of my hands have I done this. Then he knows it's wrong, doesn't he? See? They know it's wrong. All right. Now, if he was like these modern professors, he would have been terribly shocked and said, well, what do you mean? I don't understand. He understands. 4, but a bit.